The NBA just announced that they're going to be giving a bubble MVP award, as well as selecting an All-NBA bubble first team. In today's video, I'm here to break down the potential candidates for the bubble MVP and come down to one player who I think deserves it the most. Before this video starts, I just want to thank everyone who's been supporting me, as my subscriber growth has been very fast, and I encourage everyone to drop a comment on their opinions down below. If you haven't already, please drop a sub, and make sure to leave a like on the video as well. Anyways, back to the topic. It's important to understand who this award is given to. So on Google it reads, the Most Valuable Player Award is an annual National Basketball Association award given since the 1955-56 season to the best performing player of the regular season. Obviously in this case scenario, instead of the regular season, it is just in the bubble. This means that the games counted are ones that started from July 30th, 2020 to all the games played before the 2020 NBA playoffs. If you take a look at some of the most recent MVPs, 9 out of 10 of them were on teams with 60 wins or more during the season they won the award. Obviously, the one man who didn't fit in this category was Russell Westbrook, who won the award during the 2016-17 NBA season. I mean, even though OKC didn't have too much success that year, there's no way you couldn't give the award to Russ. This dude literally averaged 31-10-10. He also broke the previous record for the most triple-doubles in a single season, and the NBA just had to give the award to him. A player with the heaviest impact on their team throughout the whole league is the one that normally ends up with the MVP award. The trends with these players are ones who normally know how to fill up their stat sheets with efficiency, and more importantly, know how to win games for their team. Now that we have that out of the way, coming in at the number 5 spot, Luka Doncic. Luka has been one of the breakout players this year. In just his second season, he proved to the league that he is a top-level player and is accomplishing records that not many can achieve at his age. The Mavericks are in a playoff spot, and it seems like they're going to play the Clippers in the first round. Luka this year is averaging 29 points per game, 9.5 rebounds per game, and 9 assists per game. In the bubble, at this time of recording, he's averaging 32 points per game, 11 rebounds per game, and 11.3 assists per game. Now hold on just a second. I understand, these are way beyond MVP level numbers. But rewind just a bit, and remember when I said an MVP knows how to win games for their team?
And more importantly, know how to win games for their team.
Well yeah, the Mavericks have a losing record of 3-4 so far, and if you're only counting the games Luka's played in, they are 2-4. This is an award presented to the player that has the most success in the bubble, and even though the Mavericks have a decent season record, the record doesn't take effect towards the bubble MVP. Only two MVPs in NBA history have won the award while being on teams with losing records, which are Bob Petit on the Atlanta Hawks, or known as the St. Louis Hawks back then, and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar on the Los Angeles Lakers. That means there hasn't been an MVP on a losing team in over 40 years. Even though Doncic probably has the best numbers on this list, he's the least likely out of the top 5 players due to his poor record. At number 4, I have TJ Warren. TJ has been on absolute fire in the bubble. He's averaging a staggering 31 points per game, alongside 6.3 rebounds per game and 2 assists per game. He's been one of the bubble breakouts and is a hot topic for basketball currently. Personally, I don't think this will hold up for much longer, as he'll end up playing like he normally did prior to the bubble. TJ Warren put up 54, 34, 32, and 39 points, but also only got held down to 16 and 12 points in 2 other games. He's currently 4-2 in the bubble, and unfortunately has a minor injury that might keep him out for the next few games. He has a field goal percentage of 58 and a 52 three-point percentage, which is very impressive. Now, I place TJ at 4th because not only has he been less consistent with the points compared to the other players we'll get into, as he only dropped 16 and 12 for 2 of his games, but he also only averages 2 assists per game, which is a big factor of why he's very low on the list. It'll be exciting to see how he continues to play during the playoffs as they're matched up against the Heat. I wouldn't be surprised at all if he continues to put up some crazy amount of points. After all, he has the hot hands on his team right now, which might mean the Pacers coaching staff would give a lot more opportunities to him. Now moving on to number 3, I have James Harden. Harden is a very talented individual, and outside the bubble too, he's close to MVP worthy numbers, as he's averaging 34.4 points per game, 6.6 rebounds per game, and 7.5 assists per game this season. In the bubble, he's averaging 35.3 points per game, 9.2 rebounds per game, and 8.7 assists per game, on 54% shooting and a 37% 3-point rate. Harden has a record of 4-2 in the bubble at the time of this recording, and is the main reason for the Rockets' success. He's developed himself into one of the greatest ISO players in the league, and mainly relies on his 3-pointers and free throws during games. In the bubble, he's currently averaging the second most amount of 3-point attempts per game, and is leading the league in free throw attempts. He plays the game of basketball in a very strategic way, as he's found out how to receive calls his way in order to get to the line. The Rockets' offensive style of utilizing the small ball has allowed Harden to get a lot more assists per game, as he's able to penetrate and kick the ball out for his teammate to shoot an open shot. The small ball lineup also allows him to get a lot more rebounds per game, which has allowed him to average 9.2, which is the most for a guard in a bubble so far. This lineup has allowed him to reach some high numbers in stats, especially in the bubble. With these advantages to his size, he should have the highest chance of winning the bubble MVP award, right? Wrong. Number 2, Damian Lillard. In my opinion, Dame has really proved himself to be one of the best point guards in the league right now. I mean, there are still players like Kyrie Irving, Stephen Curry, but this year, hands down, he's been the best point guard in the league. It also seems like they're going to play the Lakers in the first round, which is going to be fairly interesting. Dame is averaging 37 points per game, 4.4 rebounds per game, and 9.3 assists per game, on 49% shooting and 42.4% from the 3-point line. I mean, despite not being able to hit clutch free throws. He's been pretty much perfect. He's shooting the ball at a high level, he's facilitating the ball well, and has led his team to a 5-2 record in the bubble so far. He's the leading scorer in the bubble by 2 points ahead of James Harden, and is also in 3rd place for assists. Dame just tied his career high with 61 points against the Mavericks, which is the most amount of points scored in the NBA restart so far. Damian Lillard is having extreme success offensively, and is leading the league in points scored in the bubble. So who can possibly be higher than Lillard? Well, I'm sure most of you guessed it. The top player that'll most likely win the bubble MVP award goes to Devin Booker. He's averaging 31 points, 4.6 rebounds, and 6.1 assists per game on a 50 field goal percentage and a 35 three-point rate. Now, I know most of you know what I'm about to say, but if you just somehow live under a rock and don't know what's going on with the Suns, they're 7-0 currently. Yeah, I honestly don't even know if they'll clinch a playoff spot, let alone make the play-in tournament, even if they go 8-0, which is going to be super unfortunate. You can't not give this man the bubble MVP, even if his numbers aren't as high as the other guys on this list, or just because they didn't make the playoffs. I mean, I'm pretty sure they still have a very low chance of making the playoffs, but either way, they're the only team to be undefeated in the bubble, and they were clearly led by none other than D-Book.
It's a bad shot.
So to the NBA, you better give this man the bubble MVP, or else I promise you, it is not going to look too well on your side of things. Anyways guys, that concludes my video for today, and those are my top 5 picks for the possible bubble MVP winner. If y'all enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. I make basketball videos and give my opinions on different hot takes around the league. I promise you it'll be worth it to hit that subscribe button, and let's try to hit 200 subs as soon as possible. I hope to see everyone again in my next video, and until then, peace out.